Cranky and the big engines were trapped at the docks. "We're sure to be safe in this shed," said Duck. But he was wrong.
Ah! "Help!"
called the engines from inside the shed.
"I can't,"
called Cranky pathetically. When the storm was over, the Fat Controller rushed to the scene of destruction.
"Chomish and Percy will help you," he called to Cranky, "and then you can help the engines."
"Oh, please, hurry,"
cried Cranky,
"and tell them I'm sorry I was rude to them."
"So it was you," murmured the Fat Controller. "I owe those engines an apology."
Thomas and Percy soon came to the rescue. And it wasn't too long before Cranky was upright again and clearing the wreckage. At last, all the engines were free.
"Oh, thank you," said Gordon. "What would I have done without you?"
"Well, I had to be rescued before I could help you."
It was a busy time at the docks. All the engines were working hard, pushing and pulling trucks about. One morning, Percy was late. He told the other engines what Cranky had said. Percy looked at the lorry.
"What's this lump of steam and scrap iron?"
he teased.
"Hold me back," replied the lorry, "so you can wipe that silly smile off your smoke box."
"Ha," said Percy, and wheeshed him loudly.
When Gordon returned from the works a few days later, he was still boasting. Percy was still fuming when he met Thomas. George had been taken to some yards to work. As he was chuffering about, Duck arrived with a train of empty trucks. George was blocking his way, and a truck was stuck on the main line. "Let me through," demanded Duck.
"I'm too busy. You'll just have to wait."
"There's no time to wait. I must clear my trucks from the main line to let Gordon through."
"Pah," said George. "Then he'll have to wait too."
Duck's driver went to complain to the station master, but the signalman had already switched the points and set the signal to allow Gordon to speed through. Suddenly, he saw a truck on the line ahead.
"Get out of my way!"
But the truck wouldn't move. Until Gordon forced it. By accident.
"There is to be a festival of flowers," announced the Fat Controller. "This sign saying best rest station will be awarded to the winner. Please help with the arrangements."
"I feel put upon," he complained to Thomas. Thomas was confused. "Put upon what? The rails?"
"No, put upon with too much work. Driver says he is too."
"Put upon? What a silly saying," replied Thomas. "Percy is being put upon.
I am, I am, I am."
"Who's this dirty little engine?" cried the trucks.
"We want Thomas or Duck."
Percy ignored them. "Put upon, put upon, that's what I am." That night, all the engines laughed at him.
"We can see what's been put upon you," said Thomas.
When Percy had been rescued, the Fat Controller spoke to his driver and fireman, then to Percy. "You do look glum," sighed Duck.
"It's the new diesel's fault," replied Bill. "He's got toothache."
"Toothache? He's got teething troubles. That means he's new, and this causes some problems. In his case, it's his cooling system." That night, the Fat Controller came to see them.
"Well, John, Bill and Ben, I've sent the new diesel back to the works. Can you manage alone?"
"Oh, yes, sir."
"Boko," whispered Bill,
"I'm sorry we were rude to you."
"And," added Ben, "the new diesel was really quite friendly."
"And you know what friends do," murmured Duck.
"Know what?" they asked. "They always say goodnight to each other."
And so they did, but they still chatted about teething troubles all night long.
The Fat Controller still uses Harold to fly above the island. But all the engines know that Harold isn't spying on them.
He is, in his way, just being very useful. But that evening, Annie and Clarabelle spoke to Thomas.
It's very nice to get compliments, but no matter what we look like, we'll always be useful, won't we, Thomas?
Then they puffed away. Meanwhile, James was collecting quarry trucks from the yard.